Hello children, today we will start new chapter, chapter 12, The Canterville Ghost. This story is written by Oscar Wilde. Let's know about the writer. Oscar Wilde as an Irish writer, poet and a dramatist, who was famous for his wit and a flamboyance. His most famous works include The Happy Prince and the other stories. The Picture of Dorian Gray, Lady Windermere's Fan, and the Importance of Being Earnest. Now, let's start this story. The Canterville Ghost is a well-known short story by Oscar Wilde, widely adopted for the screen and stage around the world. It is a ghost story with a difference. Instead of the fear and tension, human rules the story, and instead of intimidating humans, the ghost is intimidated by humans. So far, no one was insulted him in this way. He has finally met his match in a spirited, unafraid American family. Frightening them seems almost impossible. Student, this is a story. This is a short story by Oscar Wilde, and it is famous for its screen and stage around the world. It is adopted for the screen and stage. It is a ghost story with a difference. It is not like all the ghost stories. What generally happened in ghost story, then everyone feared and afraid by the ghost. But here something different. Instead of fear and tension, humans rule the story, and instead of intimidating means frightening. The humans does not frightened here. Even the ghost was frightened by humans. So far, no one was insulted him in this way. Means no one has insulted the ghost in this way earlier. He has finally met his match in a spirited, unafraid American family. And frightening them seems almost impossible. Means frightening that American family is impossible. It seems impossible. Now see the characters of the story. Lord Canterville, the owner of the mansion called Canterville Chase. Mr. and Mrs. Otis, a wealthy middle-aged American couple. They are the American couple. Mrs. Umney, the old housekeeper of the Canterville Chase. She is the old housekeeper of this chase. Washington, the eldest son of the Otis family. Washington is the eldest son of the Otis family. Virginia, the middle child and the Otis only daughter. Virginia is the only daughter of Otis family. The twins, Lewis and Clark. There's a twins whose name was Lewis and Clark, the youngest member of the Otis family. And the last but not least, the ghost. Scene 1 at the Canterville Chase. Lord Canterville, I'm really pleased you want to buy Canterville Chase, but there is something you have to know. The owner of the Canterville Chase is the Lord Canterville, and he told to anyone that I'm really very happy that you want to buy the Canterville Chase. But I want to tell you something. This is something you should know. Mr. Otis, if you insist, if you want, then you can tell me. Lord Canterville, yes, I do. There's this ghost in. Then Lord Canterville replied, yes, I will tell you. There's a ghost in. And he stopped. Mr. Otis, a ghost? Don't you talk about it. Mr. Otis replies, are you talking about a ghost? Don't tell me about this. I don't want to listen. Lord Canterville, I fear the ghost exists. I think you should listen to our family story. Then Lord Canterville replied, I fear the ghost that it exists here. Means there's a ghost in the Canterville Chase. And you should listen our family story. Mr. Otis, try me. Try means you. Why don't you try to telling me? Lord Canterville, I'll tell you what happened to my grand aunt the Dowager Duchess of Bolton. The Lord Canterville tell that I will tell you what happened to my grand aunt, whose name is Dowager Duchess of, who's the Dowager Duchess of Bolton. What happened with her, I'll tell you. Students, Lord Canterville tells Mr. Otis that there is a ghost in Canterville Chase, and Lord Canterville is a man of integrity. He wants to make sure the buyer knows that the pitfalls may be in buying his place. And Mr. Otis, being different from the usual type of people who are afraid of the ghost, is eager to close to deal. Mr. Otis don't afraid of the ghost, and he was eager to close the deal. The side of the stairs where Mr. Otis and Lord Canterville are standing is darkened, and the other side is lit up. The side of the stairs where Mr. Otis and Canterville were standing, theirs become darkened. That side darkened and other side light up. Sounds of women screaming are heard. The sound of women screaming are heard. Screaming means shouting. They heard a voice of a woman that shout. The butler and the housekeeper lead the Duchess to a chair and give her a drink of water. She sits down terrified. The butler and the housekeeper take the Duchess to the chair and they give a glass of water to the Duchess, and she sits down terrified. She becomes very afraid. Duchess, please don't me alone here. Take me away from here. She screams and said, don't leave me alone and take me from here. I don't want to leave here alone. Get away from me. Don't touch me. Get your clammy hands off my shoulders. She told to anyone, get away from me. Don't touch me and remove your clammy. Clammy means damp and cold. Remove your cold or clammy hands, we can say, from my shoulders and don't touch me. The housekeeper, my lady, calm down. There is nobody here. Look around you. Then they replied that, the housekeeper told that, no one is here, so please calm down. No one is here. And no one is touching you, so please calm down. Duchess, sobbing. Sobbing means crying noisily. That thing, it had its bony hands on me. I didn't notice at first. I thought it was a draught. Then I saw those skeleton hands. Then Duchess replied, she was crying, and told that that thing, it has its bony hand on me. There was something and whose bony hand was over me. But firstly, I didn't notice. I thought that it was a draught. Draught means a rush of unpleasant cold air blowing through a room. First time she thought that it was air that blowing in the room. She feels air, but now when she saw that there was a skeleton hands on her, so she started to crying. The Duchess screams again and faints. The side where Mr. Otis and Lord Canterville are standing is lit up. The Duchess again cried and she faint. Faint means, students, a sudden loss of consciousness. And where that Mr. Otis and Canterville were standing, that side is lit up. Lord Canterville, my grand aunt was so frightened that she never recovered from the shock. Then Lord Canterville told to Mr. Otis that my grand aunt became so frightened that that's why she never recovered from her shock. Mr. Otis, and you want to believe me this? Mr. Otis said to Lord Canterville, and what you want, that I believe this story? I believe that there's a ghost? Lord Canterville, Mr. Otis, the ghost has been seen by several members of my family, and after the unfortunate accident of the Duchess, none of our younger staff would stay with us. Lady Canterville often got very little sleep at night due to the mysterious noises that came from the corridor and the library. Then Lord Canterville replied that the ghost is not only seen by the Duchess, but it had been seen by several members of my family. And after that unfortunate incident that happened with Duchess, no one of our younger staff want to stay with us. Everyone left from here. And Lady Canterville's she was never able to take a proper sleep. She did not take a proper sleep at night due to mysterious noises, because there was lots of mysterious noises came from corridor and library, and due to that noises, Lady Canterville not able to take sleep at night. Mr. Otis is saying to me, Lord Canterville, we have not cared to live in that place ourselves. It gives you a strange, scary feeling. Lord Canterville replied that we don't care to live here now ourselves. That's why we gives you a strange, scary feeling. This was a really strange and scary feeling. Mr. Otis, my lord, I insist I will take Canterville Chase with furniture and ghost included. Then Mr. Otis said to Lord Canterville that, my lord, I will take Canterville Chase and furniture and the ghost also. You don't worry. I will board the Canterville Chase with furniture and I will board the ghost also. I will take the ghost also. So you don't worry. Lord Canterville, well, at least you have been warned. Lord Canterville replied, okay, at least you have been warned. I have told you all the things and you know everything and you know about the ghost also. Mr. Otis, we come from a modern country. We do what we want. We have money and everything that money can buy. Then Mr. Otis replied that we came from other country and we don't believe in ghosts and in all this nonsense. And we have a money and we have everything that money can buy. Lord Canterville, what is your point? Then Lord Canterville asked, what you want to say? Mr. Otis, my dear Lord, we would buy the ghost itself if there were such a thing and place it in the museum for its worth. Maybe even have a traveling ghost show. Then Mr. Otis replied, my Lord, I will buy the ghost if it is really here. Then I will buy the ghost also and place it in the museum for its worth. And maybe there have been a traveling ghost show also. Means you don't worry, I have a money and I can buy the ghost also and I don't fear and I don't believe all this nonsense. Lord Canterville, if you don't mind a ghost in your house, it's quite all right with me. But let me tell you one last time, the ghost has been around for 3 centuries and it always makes its appearance before the death of a family member. Lord Canterville said, if you don't mind, then there's a ghost in this Lord Canterville Chase, and after knowing all this thing, you want to buy this chase, then it's really a good thing. It's really all right with me that I have informed you, and you know, and after knowing all these things, you want to buy the ghost, buy this house, buy this mansion. But let me tell you one last thing, that ghost has been not here for 2 or 3 years. It has been here for 3 centuries and it always makes its appearance before the death of a family member. When? Before the death of a family member. Means it always came here and it makes its appearance before the death of the family members. Mr. Otis guffawing. Guffawing means the students, as you can see, laughing loudly. Well, so does the family doctor, Lord Canterville. The Mr. Otis saying, oh, as the doctor used to do, means if anyone is not well in a family, then doctor visit us and visit and look after the patient. That same thing the ghost used to do. It visits before the death of any family member, or it visits if anyone is ill or not well. Lord Canterville, with a knowing smile, all right, gentlemen, Canterville Chase is all yours. Then Lord Canterville saying, it's okay. Now he understand that Mr. Otis was laughing and making joke after listening all this thing. Then he's saying, okay, all things and all right, gentlemen. Now that this Canterville chase is yours. Hey, students, I've explained till here. In next video, I will explain from scene second. Thank you.